Alright, so I was going to take the bucket off, but the pins are welded in, and I don't want to have to cut all that crap out of there. So what I did is I ran chains from the bucket back to the carriage to hold it in this position, laid back and compressed. And then I ran a safety line. There's one chain on each side, and I ran another safety from the top of the bucket to the back of the backhoe on either side. And then I've got my safety props here and here. We're ready to go. Now I'm going to start taking off the front end.
And it's like 3/8 plate.
Not enough room to get this radiator out because it has stud mounts down here, so we have to take the fan loose so that we can take the belts off and then take this fan assembly off at the same time or before. If I can get it out beforehand, that would be great. Lift up, I gotta get the fan out of there. Ready? Sit, baby, sit. This must be the ether line from inside. This goes inside and there's a little cap on it. I think that's when they give it a snort of the good stuff from inside. But what do I know? This is the fuel supply.
Do you want me to hold it up or something?
I'll just have to get it higher than the tank itself. It'll stop. Yeah, we'll be replacing all the fuel lines because that just broke in two. Okay, so after removing the battery box, I was able to get to all the bell housing bolts. Fairly simple, not that bad. And I thought, well, let's see if we can get it out, just leaving the transmission in place. I don't know if it's going to work or not, because I still can't find a way to get the flywheel, flex plate, whatever you want to call it, loose from that transmission. So I'm not really sure how this is going to come apart. I had to pull the balancer, the dampener off, because there was one bolt right there in the mount. That's all there was, is just one. And I have to take all these loose because the engine has to slide forward before it can come up. So I'm going to go ahead and take this out next. And then we're going to pick it up by the lifting eye here and here, it's going to be a little difficult. I need to come in this way here, so I may need to turn this thing around, but we're getting close. So you can see here, there's no access in that bell housing anywhere to get the torque converter out. So you have to put the torque converter on the flywheel or flex plate, whatever you want to call it, before it goes in. That's crappy. That's got to be water in the oil. But I decided we just pull it out that way. I hate to do it because I worry about hurting that seal. But I figured this is old enough. I can, if that seal got damaged, I should be able to get another one and be okay. Because I'm sure we'll find something. Because it's pretty well preserved. Looks okay. Doesn't look like it was damaged at all, but I'll look at it closer. So, alright, now we're going to drain the oil out of it and find out where we're going to set this thing to tear it down. Alright, so I pressure washed this thing because it was a mess and I didn't want to be tearing apart, you know, this horribly oily, messy engine right here. And I wanted it sitting this way so I can work on either end to pull this apart. So I've drained all the oil, we've drained all the coolant. As you can see, there's like no mess. It's going to be messy, don't misunderstand. I don't wear gloves a lot, but in this case, it's going to be pretty messy. Now we're going to work on the fuel.
lines and the injectors themselves. When I take these off, I'm going to lay them with the other parts in the order they come out. And I'll always lay them from front to back. So this supply comes in to one injector and then back out to the next injector in a series. And then there's a return line over here at the end of the rail, or at the end of the injectors. Careful when I'm doing this, I want to make sure I'm not twisting this line. Make sure that the nut is coming loose. These injectors have been out before. If you guys have ever worked on any caterpillars, you're probably familiar with this. They use a lot of 12-point stuff, and this one's no different. That looks like 9/16 12-point. So we've got to take the rocker assemblies off next. It's like they're all one piece, so there's not a bridge that's going to fall off. They're all one piece. So I got the bolts out, take the end bracket off that, and then you can push the pin down through, and you just unscrew the rocker from the push rod. Now these got to go back in the same way they come off because of the wear patterns. I see a lot of people on YouTube's doing videos saying it's got to go back that way, and then you know they tell them, they just throw them in a pile, and that's not how they're intended to be used. So I'll take each one off. You can see these are so rusty. They've got bronze bushings inside there. We'll have to inspect. Make sure they're okay. And the intake and the exhaust are the injector, I should say, and the exhaust are different. So we're going to do, it just sits like this, and then you put all these back in the way they were. I don't want them falling out of there, so put my bolts in. This is the injector pull down. one bolt.
Yeah.
Ready. Now the injectors just pop out like this. This one I already popped loose, I just set it in there. Orientation until I'm ready to set them in. Let's see if they have a crush sleeve right there. Let me see one. That don't want to come out. First, we want to look at it. Well, that tip looks good. This is the injector that won't come out right here. This is that cylinder I thought was all rusted up. These Detroits don't use a head gasket as much as they use a crush sleeve kind of deal, a fire ring right here. They use O-rings to seal off the oil and the coolant. Get this cleaned up good, and then we'll have to look at it better. Right now, all the rollers look good. We won't really know until we get it cleaned up good. Yeah, you can see this one was sealing okay. This one, this is what that injector that stuck. Won't come out. So in here is basically a compression ring. It seals a combustion with this little ring here. It's a machined groove, and it's like a crush sleeve down in here. And there's one on each cylinder, and you see the O-rings here. And there's one seal that goes all the way around here to seal the head to the block, which is right here. Just as we suspected, all rusted. This one. Now this water is probably from me pressure washing this. And these valves were open for this cylinder at that time. But try and wipe that down so you can see it.
Yeah, because that one looks pretty good.
Yeah, you can see where it was sitting. See how the rings, see where the rings used to be? Right here, mm-hmm. Right here, and right here. The top of the piston was right here. That's where that one sat. While it was seized. Now you can see in here, this is where the air comes in. Again, this is what's called a scavenging engine. It requires air to come in this inlet, right? And then in here is two wheels like a blower, and that blower creates a small amount of pressure in the air box. The air box is connected to these down here. And that's how it gets shoved in. So you can see how the piston gets down below those
openings, the blower shoves the cool fresh air in, and when it does, it pushes the exhaust air out because the exhaust valves are open. But now we're going to try and turn it and look at this one, because this is the one that would never fire. There's a little bit of a something there. So now we're going to try and get the motor to turn over. Yeah, look at that. Look at the cylinder walls there. This was never going to fire. You can see how rusty it was and how glazed over. Look at the top. See how rusty that is? That cylinder was never going to fire. And this one up here, you see it was firing because it had soot. But you see here, we had it escaping past or out around. So now we're going to get something on this and try and turn that crank and see if we can get these to move now. Because the next step is pulling the oil pan. It's not expanded like it should be though. So this was one of the cylinders that was firing. It's got some wear. It's not horrible. You put these back together, there's a lock here and a lock here. They have to be against each other. Pay attention here. The lock in the bearing goes towards the exhaust side. So when you put the pistons back in, make sure they don't get in this way, they get back in that way. Interesting. I'll have to clean these up and inspect them some more later, but Unfortunately, the camera died at some point as I was tearing all this apart, but we found the smoking gun. I took the blower off and went to go turn the two gears that were out here, and it was locked up. The impeller has broken, and it was lodged down inside so that it couldn't move. So I'm not sure what was the cause of the failure. I don't know if it was fatigue on a roll pin, because these things are timed and they have to be just right for them to work together, as you can see here, kind of rolling into that one, like they'll roll in to each other kind of. So I don't know if this roll pin snapped, because it's gone, and maybe the roll pin snapped and, you know, fell down in here. I can't find any remnants, but it was jammed up, and we got scoring here, like there may have been something in there. Again, this is all speculation. You can see the edge is kind of ground up, and this side is all ground up. This one's got the same thing. So I really don't know, and it would be very difficult to say what happened for sure. But you can see how the roll pin's up here. It's not here. Now, it could be that it failed. The impeller failed, and when it did, it sheared that. I don't know. Chicken or the egg, which came first? So the inside of the housing has some pretty good scoring. There's the problem with it. So we are completely torn apart. The one injector still would not come out of that thing. And rather than me fool with it, I'm going to send the head in. I have the machine shop look it over. So I'll have to finish stripping it down. And I'm going to let them try and get that out. They may have a trick or something that, you know, I don't know about. But, yeah. You know, there's the failure. There's the, well, part of the cause and the effects, but it was locked up. So, next video, we'll be talking about what the machine shop says. I'll drop this stuff off. It's probably going to be just a little while, because when I drop it off, it takes them, you know, a little while to get a look at things. But we'll get the head and the block over, stripped down. We'll get it to them and see what they say. In the meantime, I'm going to be working on another project I've got going on. While we're waiting to hear from them, we're going to move forward on that. So that's the end of this one, guys. If you like what we're doing, give us a thumbs up. If you haven't already, hit the subscribe button. Leave your comments down below. I hope you guys are enjoying this series.